So colonoscopy in America and in Western society is one of the most well-recognized screening methods for colorectal cancer. And what colonoscopy allows us to do is identify what we call precursor lesions or polyps, as it's more generally known out in the public. There's a well-recognized sequence of events from finding a garden variety polyp in the colon and having, over time, that polyp turn into a colorectal cancer. This usually takes somewhere between 5 to 10 years, and that's why we have screening intervals set up on 3 to 5 or 5 to 10 year intervals when we find a polyp. We put people into categories, and we put them into high-risk categories, sort of low-risk categories, and then most people are sort of in between. High-risk categories are people who have a family history of a colon cancer in someone who's young. We define young as usually less than 60 years of age. We define low-risk people as people who have no family history or otherwise very healthy, or maybe with something like some high blood pressure or maybe a little bit of obesity as the only health problems they have. So for an average-risk individual who's in kind of that low-risk category, we recommend that for Caucasians they start screening at age 50, and for African-Americans that they start screening at age 40. The African-American data is fairly new over the last sort of 2 to 3 years, but seems to have a lot of merit to it in the GI literature. People do think it's painful. I always tell my patients it's not a painful procedure, it's not a comfortable procedure either, it's sort of somewhere in between, and that's why we use the sedation we do. I tell them we use a combination of medicines, that one of which is a pain medicine, and again I reiterate that it's not a painful procedure, but it can be uncomfortable. And we use that in adjunct or in conjunction with something like Valium. We don't use Valium per se, but we use one of its cousins called Versed. And the two medications together sort of work like three medications, and they have a synergistic effect. So that's sort of how I address the sedation standpoint. The bowel prep issue is one that we are always trying to tweak and make better, and there are lots of preps out there. There are Gatorade preps, there are other volume preps you can do. We've tried cutting the volume in half and adding pills, and everybody's only trying to come out with something new. The newest thing with bowel preps is what we call split dose prepping, and anybody that does a lot of scoping ought to know about this, where you drink about 2/3 of the prep the night before and about 1/3 actually the day of the procedure. It cleans the colon out much better. It's been proven in many studies. You know, from a complication standpoint, any procedure that we do endoscopically is or has complications. Most people come to find out when they talk to me or one of my partners are related to the sedation. And too much sedation is a bad thing, just like too little sedation can be a bad thing from a patient standpoint. From the procedural standpoint, complications associated with colonoscopy are pretty uncommon. I quote people about 1 in 2,500 to about 1 in 3,000 will experience a complication like a hole in the colon or some bleeding after taking a polyp off, those sorts of things. And then my answer to anybody that is older than age 50 that hasn't had one is that they should. Colonoscopy is the one test that we have in the GI world that really makes a difference every day. There are lots of fancy procedures, some of which I perform, some of which my partners perform, but colonoscopy is a gastroenterologist's bread and butter. And it allows us to screen people and treat people for polyps, and hence cut down on that risk of colorectal cancer. The cure rate when you find a polyp is really excellent. I mean, it's 100% if you find a polyp, certainly early enough. But if you find the precursor lesion, or even if you find a polyp with some precancerous cells in it and you take that out, then the survival rate is excellent. It's the folks who don't undergo the screening when they're younger and maybe when they have a change in bowel habits or they have a little blood in their stool or something like that, that is they ignore, and then unfortunately they present oftentimes with disease that's a lot of places.